Thanks for coming. This is very weird to be back up here again. So I'm here to introduce tonight's performance. So this is the first concert in our Support for Live Workers series presented by us, the Saskatchewan Festival of Words, and the Moose Jaw Cultural Centre, and funded by the Government of Canada. So before I introduce tonight's artists, I would like to take a moment to recognize that we are located on the traditional lands referred to as Treaty 4 territory, the original lands of the Cree, Ojibwe, Soto, Dakota, Nakota, Lakota, and the homeland of the Métis Nation. We respect and honor the treaties that were made on all territories, and we will continue to acknowledge the harms and mistakes of the past, and we are committed to moving forward in partnership with Indigenous nations in the spirit of reconciliation and collaboration. Now, tonight's show is featuring Juno-nominated artist Dayna Manning, who exemplifies the very best that Canadian folk music can be. Her cool, clear voice, along with her insightful songs, represent a history of Canadian musical art that goes back to the early 60s and sounds just as vital today. A modern Renaissance artist, Manning was recently nominated for the 2021 Canadian Folk Music Awards Producer of the Year for her seventh album, Morning Light, which features chamber folk arrangements by the Stratford Festival alumnus Ben Bolt Martin for flute, cello, French horn, and violin. Manning's storied 25-year career includes recording collaborations with Sean Ono Lennon, Chad Smith of the Red Hot Chili Peppers, Melanie Doan, and Ian Tamblyn, to name a few. Her touring performances include Lilith Fair, collaborations with the Spirit of the West, and tour support for both Burton Cummings and Joe Cocker. Merchandise will be for sale in the lobby at intermission and at the end of the show. So please welcome our guest, Dayna Manning.
Hi, everyone. Thank you, Amanda. That was a really nice welcome. Very educated. I'm here tonight to play music from my my body of work, and I thought it would be appropriate to play a song on my own called The Road Less Traveled, because all of these songs have come to me as I travel that road less traveled. Into my eyes, I'd like to welcome my fellow musicians on stage. You're in for a treat. I've brought some wonderful musicians with me from Ontario, and I've discovered also a brand new musician I've never played with before until yesterday, right on the bass here in Moose Jaw. And I'll tell you more about them as we go on. I started writing songs when I was 15 years old in my childhood bedroom, and I truly thought that my four walls were the only things that would ever hear the songs that I wrote. And I was lucky enough to stumble into a record deal at that time, and I released an album called Volume 1 in 1997 of 12 songs that I wrote all by myself. And I was nominated for a Juno for that album, and this song, Half the Man, was the lead single off that record, and I wrote it when I was 16.
Shakespeare thoughts out of his head as he smokes a dentist's cigarette. Can't bring himself to get out of bed 'cause he likes the thoughts running. Thank you.
album led to an opportunity to kind of make the next album any way I wanted to. And I was asked by my record company who I wanted to meet in the industry and who I might want to work with. And I spent a little bit of time traveling around North America, meeting writers and producers. And I was introduced to a man named Eric Bazilian, and he was really famous for writing the song "What If God Was One of Us" for Joan Osborne. Do you remember that song? It was really neat because he told me that he actually wrote it with the singer from Crash Test Dummies in mind singing it, and he had a recording of it at his house with Brad from that band singing it, which was an incredible thing. I always thought they should release it. We got together and he had a lyric, "I'm working on a miracle," and I had a guitar riff, and we wrote this song together, and it's called "Miracle." Well, that one's a fun one to play. That was Laura Chambers on the rock flute, which we all need more of in our lives. After that album, which was released again by EMI and Network in the States, and quite an adventure for me, I ended up back in my hometown of Stratford, Ontario, thinking about what I might want to do next. And I decided to release an album on my own called Folkio, and I wrote this song called Anytown, wondering where my career might lead. You know, the taste of being on the road and being everywhere wasn't maybe like everything I wanted it to be. I wanted to have a family, and I wanted to be with near my parents and all the normal things. So I wrote this one called Anytown with my friend Gavin, thinking about where this all would go next.
Sometimes I love this place, and sometimes I don't. Some days everything goes my way, some days it just won't. I sit around and plan what I can do to get what I want, but I spend too much time thinking of everything I'm not. But of all the lost and found, yeah, no one's held me down. If you were waiting around too long, you might find your chances gone. Be forced to take it all in stride. Stories about where I've been and what I did, and we all suspect each other.
So I always predict my life in song, and I ended up moving away from Stratford, worried that, you know, I might spend the rest of my life there. And I somehow ended up on the Alaska Highway, and I lived there for several years near a place called Charlie Lake. Has anyone heard of Charlie Lake? It's a beautiful little spot just north of Fort St. John. And one night, I was out there with my friends. I was invited to a barbecue at a friend's place who had a dock on the lake. And after dinner, they asked me to play a few songs, and the stars all came out, and then the northern lights came out like I had never seen them before. They were rainbow colors, and they taught me that if I whistled at the northern lights, they would dance. So about 15 people were standing on a dock going, and I'll absolutely never forget it. It was an incredible experience. I had to be somewhere in the morning, so I drove back to town, and I noticed everyone. I actually had to watch that I didn't hit people with their phones trying to record them, you know, in the middle of the road. Anyhow, I was very inspired, so I started reading more about Charlie Lake. I had already known that there was a cave up on the bank of the lake where some of the first evidence of human life in North America was found. And at the time I wrote the song, it actually, I believe, was the earliest evidence. Simon Fraser University did an excavation of this site, and they also found two ravens that were buried in a certain way that they thought was also one of the first signs of spirituality in Canada. So it was really, really significant. And you could feel that energy at this place. When I was living there in 2008, they also erected a monument for 12 men who lost their lives in the lake. They drowned when they were sending a barge of equipment across the lake, building the highway. And so I just really felt that these lights we saw were all these spirits that were eternally connected to this lake. And I wrote this song called Charlie Lake.
I heard a rumor I could find you at the new frontier. I kept fixing my hair, checking my lips in the mirror. A two-step, back step, turn around and dip your head back, cowboy. Shake those lazy hips in my direction. Eternal connection. Such a beautiful sight for a cold, dark night. But you've acted strange since those 12 men drowned. Yet I forget all about it when you dance around. And they told me if I whistled, you would dance all night, all night. And so told me if I whistled, you would dance all night.
Just behind me is Ben Bolt Martin on the cello. Ben is the musical director, and he did all of these arrangements for these songs. So he's the one who just made the Northern Lights come alive for us all. I wanted to say thank you for coming tonight. I appreciate how hard it is to even make a decision whether to come out right now, and I really am glad that you're here. And I wanted to say hello to everyone at home watching on the live stream. It's really exciting that to know that you're here too, and I want to say hi to my family, Steve and Claudia, and my mom and dad. So thanks for being here. This next song, I co-wrote this with a man named Bill Lishman. Does that ring a bell, that name, to anyone? Bill Lishman was also known as Father Goose, and he is the man who taught the Canada geese to follow him in his ultralight aircraft when they didn't know to fly south. So he told me that basically if anything happens to Mother Goose, the birds don't know to fly south. It's not an instinct that they're born with. It is a learned behavior. And so I'm from Stratford, Ontario, and we sure have a lot of Canada geese hanging around in the winter. Because somewhere down that line, they've forgotten how to do this. So Bill is an incredibly eccentric man. I just heard this story. I've always been fascinated with flying, which is kind of how I ended up here in Moose Jaw singing for you, and I'll tell you more about that later. And I started writing this song. I loved Bill's story that he was able to, you know, look beside him and see a Canada goose. So I called him up out of the blue and said, hey, I'm trying to write this song, but I need more insight. I don't know, I don't feel emotionally connected enough, and I need you to kind of put me on the right path. So he shared a poem with me that he wrote, and I wrote it into the song. So now we've co-written this song. But a little bit more about Bill. He was a welder by trade. He made all the amazing sculptures at Canada's Wonderland. He built a lunar landing module full size in his backyard based on a small model that he bought. And I was able to premiere this song in his living room on Earth Day. But he lived in an underground geodome that he built and designed himself. He's an absolutely incredible, forward-thinking man. I always speak about him in the present because he's always with me, but he did pass away a few years ago. And I sing this in his honor, and I was honored to sing this at his celebration of life. So Bill will probably join us today.
One.
for Canada, I was missing a part of my soul. Never knew that a man could have been so kittered with some geese in a row. Oh, that so many folks would hear our tale and reach out. It's been decades of connections through hearts with no doubt. Emotion stirs so powerful, you see the epiphanies and tears. And sure as spring will come.
I don't know if you'll recognize the violin player, but she's the admin over at the wing. She usually has her hair up, and she was really excited to wear it down tonight. This is Margaret Carey. Margaret just joined us last night for a rehearsal and is playing the show tonight for the first time. She's an incredible musician from right here in Moose Jaw. I can't believe it, but we're at the end of set one already, and we're going to take a small intermission. I always go out to the merch table if you want to come say hi at intermission and after the show. It's really important to me to meet you and thank you for coming. So if you'd like to say hi, I'll be out there, and we're going to leave you. I thought we should definitely play a Saskatchewan song. This is called Free Man in Paris by the one and only Joni Mitchell.
Side. You know I'd go back then and
Thank you so much. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Thank you.
hope you had a nice break. We did. I mentioned before that I'm from Stratford, Ontario. It's a really special place to be from. We have a world-renowned Shakespearean theater festival that expands to musicals and all kinds of amazing things. And because of that, we have an incredible amount of skilled musicians and professionals that live there in this little town of 30,000. And that's kind of how I met all these folks. Also, we have a long history of great musicians from our town. And one of them is Richard Manuel, who was the keyboard player in The Band. You know The Band? Yeah. Yeah, he's amazing. Richard was born and raised in Stratford with his three brothers, and they all learned to sing at a Baptist church just around the corner from my house. And he had the most beautiful voice, but he was always in the background playing, backing up someone else like Dylan or Ronnie Hawkins. And he tried to kind of launch a solo career in the late 70s, early 80s, and it really got him down, and we lost him to a mental illness, and he committed suicide after a show one night in the 80s. And it really affected my musical community. And I remember my peers' parents talking about him. And I wanted to write a song in dedication to Richard, and it's called King of the Background.
Thank you. torture.
Thank you. When I finally left the northern BC area and made my way back to Stratford, Ontario, I started a group for kids called the Folk Army, and they play ukulele and learn guitar and write songs, and it's mostly girls. I never ever made it for just girls, but just girls kind of signed up because I think they saw me playing guitar and wanted to learn. And it has been one of the most great experiences of my life. I wrote this song called The Same Way, thinking about going back to Stratford and teaching these kids. And I modeled it off of the salmon who lay their eggs in a freshwater river, go out to sea, and somehow figure out where they came from and come back. So this is called The Same Way. And at the end, you'll hear the salmon, you know, they give up their life to create new life, and you'll hear that happen at the end.
I want to explore. Isn't there always more to be seen, to be had, to be done? Oh, and everyone knows that you can't move on, heading back the same way that you came. And so I follow the tide and the sun's going by, and my heart never challenged the wind. All because, baby, deep inside, there were needs I can't deny. And so I turned this around, it was homeward bound. I headed back. But my heart knows it'd be a mistake. Oh, because, baby, deep inside, there were needs I can't deny. And so I turned this around, it was homeward bound. I headed back the same way that I came. Someday you'll go the very same way.
Thank you. I couldn't be a bigger fan of Canadian singer-songwriters, Neil Young and Joni Mitchell and Burton Cummings and all of them. And so I love to play their songs in my set. I had the honor of being invited to a Gordon Lightfoot tribute show that Gordon Lightfoot attended. And I got to play this song for him. It's called Love and Maple Syrup. It's off my favorite Gordon Lightfoot album, Summer Side of Life. One, two, three, four.
Love and maple syrup go together like the sticky winds of winter when they meet. When lonely lovers come to rest beneath the trees, they do their best, but still they can't be free.
Thank you so much. How are you guys doing? How many of you are here for your first concert in 2 years? Okay, that's quite a few. Thank you. I hope you're feeling good and having a good time. I am. I wish you could have seen the smiles on our faces last night when we rehearsed for the first time. It's been a while. So this song, there's kind of two bad times of year to sing this song, and one of them is right now. The other time is October, where there's impending doom. It's called Oh Snow. This song I wrote long before the pandemic, and I was thinking of the snow day and how wonderful the snow day is. It's that gift of time. And we have been given a lot of time recently, so its effect isn't as strong anymore. Although, I still love a snow day. I played this for a group of kids this morning here in Moose Jaw on Zoom, and they loved the snow day. They all loved the snow day.
Keep that all inside. Send it on down, blow it all around, cover my porch and my car. I don't mind, no plans to get real far. How I love the thought of staying inside, getting locked down with a glass of wine might be why I haven't moved. If I get real lucky, my love will come by and we'll snuggle up and light this fire and melt away. Oh, and you can do your thing. Oh, without worrying that you're getting. Be hard to be falling all the time. Everybody thinks you've been pushing us around, but I know we're bringing you down. The more I see of you, the more I know we've done you wrong. But I love the way you bury the past, keep our eyes forward, slow down the fast. Wherever we go, sense a flake of resent, my back's been bitter in the shells of bitch, and my fingers are cold. Still I try to understand. Oh, I know it's with forced hands when don't feel bad. Sometimes you make my day.
Thank you.
I always think that Ben orchestrated us into our own snowbank. I've got one more song before a special guest is going to come. I have connections here in Moose Jaw. This song is called Save Me, and it is Mother Earth speaking to humanity. Doom, doom, doom. Sorry, restart. I started that in the wrong key. I thought something was wrong. I had to do something. One, two,
save me, oh save me, oh save me. Save me, save me, save me, I will forgive you.
Well, we do have a special treat for you because I happen to know one of the best singers in Moose Jaw. Come on up. This is Rich McDougal. I don't know if you want Richard McDougal. I should have clarified that. Rich and I have sang together before. We've sang the national anthem together, but this is the first time we're going to do kind of an official duet. Come on out. Do you mind bringing me that stand? Rich picked this awesome song for us to do, and so we've been jamming it, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for joining me. How are you doing?
Good.
Good? It's fantastic, yeah. I might scoot it over. I'm a little blind. How are you doing? Feeling good?
Terrified.
Are you? No way. He's such a pro. I couldn't believe when I heard Rich sing for the first time, and I had to make sure that we did something together while I was here. So thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
Tell him about this song.
Well, it's a Maren Morris and Niall Horan duet.
Yeah.
And I thought it fit both of our voices, and thought we'd give it a go.
All right.
I have seen it all in paper dreams, watched it unfold on the screen, but I never understood. Talking to me first, never thought you would. Oh my, my, you just took me by surprise, and I can't believe my eyes. Oh, I must be seeing blind. Oh no, you're too good to be on mine. Now I'm looking in your eyes. Oh, I must be seeing. But you make loving fun. I never knew it could be. And I see you from a different point of view. Seems too good to be true. I found my missing. A sight I can't describe. Oh, I must be seeing blind. Oh, my, my, you just took me by surprise, and I can't believe my eyes. Oh, I must be seeing blind. Oh, no, I, you're too good to be on mine. Now I look into your eyes. Oh, I must be seeing blind.
Thanks, Rich. I met Rich through my partner, Steve McDonald, who that song makes me think of. long story short, this is the end of the show. This is the last song. If you clap really loud, we might play another, but we're going to play a song called Freedom that years ago I wrote in honor of the snowbirds here in Moose Jaw. And I was singing the anthem at an air show. I get asked to sing anthems from time to time up in northern BC. And I met a fella named Mike French, who ended up being the CEO of the Snowbirds just recently. But back then, I think he was number three. And he said, "Hey, are you Dayna Manning?" And I said, "Yeah, you're a snowbird." And he goes, "Yeah, well, my wife and I have come to all your shows in Winnipeg. I'm a big fan, and if you ever write anything with the Snowbirds in mind, let me know. We fly to a lot of Canadian music." So I kind of tucked that in the back of my head, and then I did write them a song, but I didn't tell them. Mike wasn't on the team anymore. I just kind of wrote a dedication in an album. And on Canada Day in 2013, I heard from one of the Snowbirds that said, "Hey, we hear you're singing the anthem at Parliament Hill. We're here too, and that you have a song about us, so we'd love to get your CD." So I handed off my CD to this fella, and now I've seen the Snowbirds fly to my song like four times. It's just the coolest thing ever. And now my partner is an ex-Snowbird. It's just like the weirdest story. But basically, I wrote myself into the love of my life. But that is not how, yeah, it's crazy. but that is not how the story has gone for the last decade. You know, like the story has evolved and changed. But anyway, it's an honor to play this at the home of the Snowbirds. And this one's for you guys. For all of Moose Jaw, thank you for having us. Oh wait, that's Stefan Sesniak. Yeah. He's a legend, keeping us together, and it's so nice to play with Stefan.
A one, a two, a one, two, three.
Baby, strong and free. When it's on the rocks, you gotta get out. And when the night is long and the sun's coming low, you gotta close your eyes and get on the go. Freedom is a promise of mine. You gotta
Okay, we'll play you another one. I hate encores. So awkward. I wanted to play this song because I hear this is the recent home of Burton Cummings. He, believe it or not, when I was 18 years old, he took me across Canada opening all of his Up Close and Alone shows. And before I even had a record deal, I was on a tour bus in PEI and we went all the way to Vancouver Island, and he was so kind to me and looked after me so well. His whole crew showed me Canada and taught me how to be a performer and to tell stories and to write songs. And his best advice he ever gave me was, Dayna, if you want to make it in the music business, write a song like this. And then he played Strawberry Fields by the Beatles. Burton carries around lucky rocks that he will not get on the stage without. And I have searched high and low for those rocks before a show. And I actually have my own lucky rocks in my guitar case that he gave me when I was 18 years old, and I bring them everywhere. One of them is even demolished, but it's still in the bag, and they're right there backstage. I should have brought them out to show you. Anyhow, he did teach me this song on piano when I was young. Burton likes to sleep in, so he would miss sound check, and I would sound check his piano for him, so I would pretend to play These Eyes, but I wasn't playing the right chords. And so one day he walked on stage and said, no, Dayna, it goes like this, and showed me. But here it is on guitar. Hope you enjoy it. This one's for Burton and for all of you, and thank you for coming tonight and joining us. We'll come out and say hi after.
These eyes cry every night for you. These arms long to hold you again. Pardons on me, yeah. I was never be free. Watched you bring my world to an end. Maybe, baby, it's harsh. Cannot accept or pretend. Hardened on me, yeah. I will never be free. No, no, baby, no. Made a vow to me. are crying. These eyes have seen a lot of love, but they're never gonna see another one like I had with you. These eyes are crying. These eyes have seen a lot of love, but they're never gonna see another one like I had with you. These eyes are crying. These eyes have seen a lot of love, but they're never gonna see another one like I had with you.
Thank you so much. Thank you to my band. I couldn't have a better band to play with. And thank you to Matt, Derek, running the show here, Amanda, Sarah, and everyone with the Festival of Words who put this on. It is so important to fight to have arts back in our lives. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Have a great night, everyone.